For this first video, what me and Ashley did was either me or Ashley would go up to a customer that was just walking out of the store and ask them to hold Murphy, the dog. And then, say I told the person to hold Murphy, then I would run to the store and then Ashley would run back out wearing the same jacket as me and then take the dog and be like, oh, thank you. And they're experiencing change blindness, so which is like they were unable to see that me and Ashley were different people because they weren't really focused on us. Like, they were just kind of focused on the situation. Change blindness. So I dropped the dog off to you, and then she came out to get the dog to see if you noticed.
Oh,
you know,
I didn't.
You didn't?
Okay. I just noticed you guys had long hair.
So, do you mind if we use your video in our video? It's not going on YouTube.
Only one person will see it. Is our teacher?
Only our teacher will see it.
Okay.
It was beautiful today.
You should look on the video. Yeah.
So just our teacher.
Okay, so one other experiment we did with change blindness was we were in the store checking out a product or whatever we were buying, and I would go to the cash register and purchase the item, and when the cashier took my money and turned away, I would duck below the counter, and Kylie would pop up and finish the transaction, and they would not even know that we're different people. So this next few videos will just be showing change blindness as well.
Thank you.
hey, can you watch my dog while I go inside and grab something? They're like, sure. And then I went inside and grabbed something, and she came back out and said, thanks for watching my dog.
Yeah.
And they, one lady noticed. She's like, hey, you're the wrong person.
Yeah. Thank you.
Because you guys can, I mean, you are a little taller, but you kind of,
yeah,
at a quick glance, you look similar. So.
Yeah.
That's the whole point of it, though, right?
Yeah. We don't want to be completely different.
Okay.
Thank you.
No problem.
These next two experiments, we experimented with Piaget's childhood development stages, which we experimented on the pre-operational, which lasts approximately between the ages of 2 and 7, and Colton is age 6. So he started catching on to a few of the experiments, but for the most part, he's still in the pre-operational stage. So we're doing the milk glass experiment. We're recreating it. We're using water instead, and
how old are you?
6.
And what are you doing today? What do you think you're gonna do?
Science?
No, not science. We're doing psychology. Kind of close.
Yeah, yeah, you're close.
So can you tell me which glass you think has more water in it?
This one.
Why do you think that?
Because it's long and it could have more water.
Oh, okay. Good job, Colton.
Okay, Colton. Which glass has more water in it right now? This one. Okay. You see how high the water goes right there?
Yep.
Alrighty. Alright. Now, if you were to remember last time how much water was in this one, remember? A few seconds ago? Now you see how much water is in this one?
Yeah.
Which one has had more water? Did this one have more in it, or did this one?
Yeah, why?
Explain why.
Good job.
Good job, buddy. I think this is fair. You get this and I get this. Mm-hmm. Why not?
Because this one's more and this one's less.
Mm-hmm. I have 2 and you only have 1. Alright, so what if I make it fair? Try and make it fair. Is that fair now? You both have 2. Why not?
Because this one's bigger.
It is? Alright. Yeah, it's smarter.
So for this last video that you just watched, we did another pre-operational experiment when Taylor had a bigger graham cracker than Colton, and when Taylor asked Colton who has more, he said Taylor does. So Taylor broke hers into broke Colton's into 2 pieces and asked him who has more, and Colton still thought Taylor
had more. This shows that the boundaries for the pre-operational stages are kind of gray, and there's no set age for where.